We're asked to use fraction pieces to name the different fractions. The red circle represents the unit. For these problems, we'll be using the fraction pieces tool from the National Library of Virtual Manipulatives. Here's the URL to the site, and here's the URL to the actual tool. Now, one thing I should mention is that depending on what fraction pieces you're using, the colors may be different, but the strategy will be the same. Let's take a look at A and B together, where A is one green piece and B is three green pieces. So the red circle is the unit. Here we have green pieces. We'll begin by determining how many green pieces it takes to make one whole. So there's two green pieces makes up one whole, which means each green piece is equal to 1/2. So again, one green equals 1/2. Next we have three green pieces, which would be three copies of 1/2. So there's one green, two greens, and there's three greens. So three greens equals three copies of 1/2, which equals 3/2, which we can also express as 1 and 1/2. So three green pieces is equal to 3/2, which equals 1 and 1/2. 3/2 is a fraction, 1 and 1/2 is a mixed number. The next four deal with gray pieces. We have one gray, three gray, four gray, and six gray. We'll begin by determining how many gray pieces make up one whole. So 1, 2, 3, 4 grays make up one whole, which means each gray piece is equal to 1/4 of one whole. So one gray equals 1/4. Three gray pieces would be three copies of 1/4. So there's 1, 2, 3 gray pieces. Notice three gray pieces is equal to 3/4. Next we have four grays. Well, we already have three gray pieces here. Notice the fourth gray piece makes up one whole. So 4 grays is equal to 4/4, which equals 1. Next we have 6 grays. We know 4 gray pieces makes up one whole. Let's move this off the working area. Bring in another unit. We want 6 gray pieces, so here's 4, 5, 6. So 1 gray is equal to 1/4, so 6 grays is equal to 6/4, but we can also express this amount using larger pieces. If we go back to the green pieces, where each green is equal to 1/2, notice how 2 gray pieces is equal to 1 green piece, so 2/4 is equal to 1/2. Let's move this off the working area. And we'll move the 4/4 to the 4 grays back onto the working area. Notice how the 4 gray pieces are equal to 2 greens, or 2/2. So we can say 6/4 is equal to 3/2, which equals 1 and 1/2. So 6/4 is equal to 3/2, which equals 1 and 1/2. 3/2 is the simplified form of the fraction 6/4. We can say a fraction is simplified if we use the largest possible fraction pieces, or more formally, if the numerator and denominator only share a common factor of 1. The next three parts deal with orange pieces. We have 1 orange, 8 orange, and 13 orange. We'll begin by determining how many orange pieces make up one whole. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Notice 6 orange make up 1/2, so it should take 12 orange pieces to make up one whole. There's 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So because it takes 12 orange pieces to make up one whole, we know each orange piece is equal to 1/12. So again, 1 orange equals 1/12. Next we have 8 orange pieces. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's rearrange this. So this would be 8 copies of 1/12, which equals 8 twelfths. But let's see if we can express this using larger fraction pieces. Let's take a look at the purple fraction pieces here. First, notice how it takes 1, 2, 3 purple pieces to make up one whole, which means each purple is equal to 1/3. And notice how it takes 1, 2 purple pieces to make the same amount as 8/12. So now we know 8/12 is equal to 2/3. So 8 orange pieces represents the fraction 8/12, which equals 2/3. Again, 2/3 is a simplified form of the fraction 8/12. And then finally we have 13 orange pieces. Well, remember it takes 12 orange pieces to make up one whole. So here's 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We want 13 orange pieces, which would be 13/12, or 1 1/12. I hope you found this helpful.